would like to take a moment to introduce a friend of ours, a friend probably of many of yours. He has been associated in one way or another with the choruses at the senior high school for a long time. And we'd like to have him come out each year and help with the program. This year he's directing a number with the senior chorus, and without further ado, I'd like to bring him out, Mr. Morgan. mass exodus or a mutiny. But for the next song, several of the students from the combined ensemble behind me are going to be singing Away From Us. So, the Echo Carol. Small ensemble that's now coming back in that sang the Echo was directed by the sophomore chorus president, Adam Hallam, who's coming right there.
How far is it to
9 years ago so that when we wanted to travel, we could go to places where smaller ensembles were required. It's very difficult to travel with the ensembles that you've already seen when the only place big enough is for 15 or 20 or 30 people. So originally, this group started as an after-school activity, and about 3 years ago, it became a scheduled class. So on top of all the other work that these students have to do in their regular choruses, they volunteer for this. December is an extremely busy month for these people. They have just come off of what amounts to a tour. They finished 16 performances in the past 20 days, 19 days. So they've been very, very busy and very active in the community, and many of you may have already had an opportunity to see them. It is a great joy for me and a great pleasure for me to get to work with people of this caliber. These students are some of the finest I've ever seen. And just to show you that I'm not the only one that thinks so, I picked them to be in the group. But I want them to, we do this when we travel, and I want you to see this too. In our choruses, the students are elected to officer or section leader positions by their fellow students, not by me. So they're student leaders, picked by students, guiding the students in their own ensembles. How many of you are section leaders or officers in your regular chorus? These are some of the most dedicated young people I've ever had the pleasure of knowing. They work so very hard, and they should be very tired after their performance tonight. And the parents of these students owe you a big thank you also, because you've been hauling them around for the past month to get them ready to perform with us. There's going to be another presentation a little bit later on, but I'll let someone else talk about that. Now we'll just go on with the next number.
The same thing, not only because it's a good cause, not only because it serves the people in our area, but because the Blue Cross generously decided to double whatever we provided for the group. So we saw that as an opportunity to really do something very good. So we got together and we decided to do some extra things above and beyond what we normally do. We went Christmas caroling. Some of you may have seen us on your doorsteps, and We did two performances at Sam's Club, and in addition to what we normally do at Shop and Save and what we collect from our local performances, we've been very busy, and we worked very hard, and we wanted to raise a little bit more. We raised a lot more, and I'm very honored to say that we raised exactly $1,000 this year. Thank you. And that $1,000, the Blue Cross will put an additional $1,000 for $2,000 for the Community Service Club and the Carry Team, and hopefully that goes a long way. And I think it's good. Mr. Michello always says this wherever we go, and all the bad things you hear today about teenagers, it's good to hear something like this. You know, a group like this gives back to the community, and I'm honored to be a part of this group. Is Mr. Kane in the audience? Mr. Kane? He's on his way? Mr. Kane, on behalf of the West Allegheny Show Choir, I'd like to present to you a check for $1,000 for the Caring Team.
Thank you very much.
It's my pleasure. Thank you. The show choir would also like to thank you, because without you, this donation wouldn't be possible. Thank you.
night was born the child, the Christmas rose, the King of love and light.
The angels sing, the shepherds sing, and with all rejoice, the heavenly rejoice, and at his blessed birth.
all their help. Number one, a lot of the students
work very hard. Have been that way the whole time? That figures. They worked very, very hard to do the decorations. They were in here all week and
working in and out, even with the schedule that they had and a couple other programs going on in here this week. They did their best to get this ready, and I think they did a fabulous job. I also need to mention to you that this concert is being videotaped by our videography classes, and the tapes will be for sale out in the lobby before you leave. They're $12 a piece. They'll be edited. They'll have everything that you need. All you have to do is fill out a form tonight, and we'll give them to the students the day that they get back from break. So we want to thank Mr. Kane and all his students who worked so hard for that. Also want to thank the National Honor Society students who are here to help us with tickets and with programs. That's one of the things with National Honor Society. They do service, and that's a great service to us. It allows us to do things that we need to do backstage. At this time, I would like to introduce again an old friend of ours, Mr. Stuart Morgan, who will direct the Alleluia Chorus and alumni. If we could have some lights in the house, please come up on stage and join us.
You can hear? Okay. It is seriously a very great honor for me to direct the kids that I just did, and I think they did a splendid job. Thank you a lot for what you did. It makes me very proud to have had a little bit to do with the background of this, and for the alumni, most of them I've had and worked with them. They are great also, and so being sort of a little older than they are, I don't believe in just retiring and sitting down and twiddling my thumbs and doing nothing. Although I do have a sign on my dresser that says there are three things to do today. One, you get up. Two, you survive. And three, you go back to bed. So I don't think I'll do that quite yet. So it's my honor to direct this, and it is traditional from way back when for the audience to stand during this. So if you don't mind, you can stand up and stretch.
Hallelujah.
you can sit back down now, and we'll bring the 9th and 10th grade in, and we'll finish this up. Just one second. Right there. Collectively, ladies and gentlemen, I believe there are about, over 300 people about to sing for you. So that's a pretty good sized group. Before we finish our last two numbers, thank you all for coming. Have a safe trip home. Have a nice holiday. See you in the spring.